Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you are doing fine. Children, we are going to start up a new chapter, Safe Usage of the Computers. So let us get started with that. Safe use of computers. So let us start with a small story here. Aunt Stephanie and five chums, chums in the sense, the children, prepared a presentation on hacking to sensitize and safeguard people of the society. Yes. So what do you mean by the word hacking, children? It is entry of someone into other's computer without their permission. It's not necessary that they go and use the computer through internet. For example, you are using your computer in your houses, right? So what will I do sitting at my house using my computer, using my own computer, with the help of internet, I can enter into your computer and you will not be able to know also. If your computer is switched off also, I can still get into your computer and then steal all the information. Yes, maybe your computer is having lots of bank information, passwords, everything. What will I do? Without your knowledge, using the internet, I will come into your computer and take all the information and transfer all your money to me. It can be done, but children, it is wrong, right? So we have to protect our computers from hacking. Who are the people who hack? There are many people who wants to do such kind of theft, either money theft or information theft. Like for example, if I have to talk about information, imagine your madam has given you a project to do it. Yes, you did a project. Teacher asked you to make a project, okay, on different computers available. So everybody has to do it their own. So your friend wanted to know what project you are doing, because your friend was not getting any idea. If you ask, will you tell? No, because your teacher has said you that there will be marks for it. Okay, so if you are getting marks, will you share your information to others? No, right? It will be like a cheating. So what your friend did, without informing you, he went into your computer and took all your ideas and project. And the next day, before you could submit, he has submitted to the teacher. Yes. Did he do any efforts there? No. He just copied all your this one using internet. He hacked your computer and took all the information from that. This is the way you can take the information also. So there are many people sitting in the world who are hackers, who just are behind taking all your information from your system for different reasons. So what are you supposed to do? You should keep your computer safe with lots of security. Okay, do you keep your mobile phone without a password? No, right? Why? Because if your mobile phone, somebody gets your mobile phone, they will not be able to open. Why? Because you have so much information in that. You have your private photos, private information, private chats, emails, everything, yes, which you do not want to share with anybody. Likewise, even your computer, you have to safeguard. Yes, we put password to computers, but these hackers, they have good software programs which can break your password if it is a simple password. Yes, that's the reason there are different types of security to safeguard of your computer. So let us go ahead with the chapter. Aunt Stephanie and five chums prepared a presentation on hacking to sensitize and safeguard people of the society. So this Aunt Stephanie, she with these five children, she prepared a presentation so that she can tell her society people how to safeguard their computers from getting hacked. they decided to prepare series of the presentation and distribute the same to all members of the society. So what they did, so they wanted to let everybody know it. So it was difficult for everybody to come at one place and do it. So what they decided to make series, copy the presentation into the series and distribute the same CD to everybody so that they can sit at home and watch the presentation and get the knowledge of it. Mr. Soffan, who is Dobo's father, okay, who lives nearby society. So Mr. Dobo, one among these chums was Dobo. So Dobo's father, Mr. Soffan, he used to live near the society only. On hearing the news, when he got to know that this Mrs. Aunt Stephanie, she was doing this project, so he wanted to visit her. So on hearing the news, visited Aunt Stephanie, who is their family friend. Aunt Stephanie narrated the entire episode and introduced him to the five chums. So she introduced them to the five children. Bill informed, one among the child was Bill. Bill informed that they have prepared a presentation and are now copying the presentation in the CD so that they can educate other members of the society also. So Mr. Soffan checked Aunt Stephanie's computer. He was checking. So after he got to know all the information, so he went and sat on the Aunt Stephanie's computer and also the presentation prepared by the five chums. After seeing the state of Aunt's computer, Mr. Soffan offered to educate Aunt and the five chums the basic of how to keep the computers healthy and functional. So when he was using Aunt's computer, he saw that Aunt's computer is very old and it is not functioning properly. So he thought he should tell everybody how to keep the computers healthy and functional. Aunt Stephanie, Mr. Soffan, is there anything wrong with the computer? Mr. Soffan said, there is no antivirus installed in your computer system and also security setting of the web browsers are not activated. Thus, you are an easy prey for the hackers. So what Mr. Soffan wanted to say here is, antivirus. Children, we all know the meaning of virus. Yes, those are present in the air. Nowadays, we have learned about COVID virus a lot, right? It's a virus which attacks our body. So there are different virus, software virus, which attack our computers also. How do the computers get virus? Either from the files which we download from the internet or we use someone's pen drive which already has a virus in that, CDs which already has a virus in that. So such kind of things will put virus in our computer. Okay, now if you want to remove this virus or if you want to keep your computer safe so that the virus does not attack, you have to use antivirus, exactly like how we are using vaccines. So before the virus attacks, what are we doing? Preparing our body that if any virus comes, our body should be able to struggle. So for that, what did we take? Vaccine. So likewise, the way our body is taking vaccines, children, each computer needs such vaccine so that they are also virus free. So this particular vaccine in the computers, we call it as an antivirus. Yes. So what is antivirus? It's not a vaccine, okay? Remember, it's not an injection to be put to your computer, but it is also a software program. If you put that software program, antivirus software program inside your computer, so whenever you download something from the internet or whenever you're using someone else's pen drive, CDs, which is having virus, we don't know whether it is having or not, right? So if it's having some virus, children, our computer will intimate us immediately saying that there is a virus in your computer. Stop it here only. Yes. Then we will be able to delete that virus. Yes. And also the security settings of the web browser. So whenever we use internet, right, we use through web browser. This Chrome, Internet Explorer, what are they? They are the web browsers. Yes. So whenever we use such kind of web browsers, we have to do lots of security settings so that whenever we are using the web browsers, what all information we have searched or we have opened, whatever files we have opened, our email ID, bank account on the web browsers should not be tracked by someone else. Yes. See, if you want to open a bank account, yes, or you're opening your bank account on your online computer, what will you do? You have to put your name and password. Yes. So imagine I am keeping a check on your web browser. Your web browser is not secured. There is no security. There is no password for your web browser. So it is open. So anybody sitting at any place, hackers can see your information. What will you do? You'll put your password and your email username, and I will copy it from there. From internet, I'll copy it. And the next time when you are not on the system, I will open your bank account and I'll take all your money to my account. That's why it is necessary that you block it. Yes, you do full security setting. You put lots of password there. Yes, so these are the two important few of the two important aspects that you should put: antivirus and check the security settings of your web browser. So auntie said, what do you mean by security setting of the web browser? What do you mean by security setting of the web browser? Arya, another boy from the group who was listening to this conversation, also requested Mrs. Offen to guide them further so that they can modify their presentation before they distribute the same to the people of the society. Mr. Soffan, in today's world, it is mandatory to protect our computer system from hackers who are almost active everywhere. Yes? As I said, children, it is very important and compulsory to protect our computer system from the hackers, because all the information we do it from our mobiles, our computers, all are being observed by the hackers who are always active on internet to take your information. The main pathway through which malware attacks the system is the internet. Yes, what's the malware? Are nothing but these different kinds of viruses or people who are sitting to take all the thefts or put the software programs to spoil your computer so that your computer gets crashed. Yes, so to make these things away, you should have a main pathway through which a malware attacks the system in the internet. Yes, so what is the malware? Malware is a malicious software program to steal sensitive and confidential data from any computer over the internet. So what do you understand by malware? It's malicious in the sense some program which is having a capability of spreading fast in the computer system. So what they do, they copy paste themselves. Imagine I will put one virus malware software in your program. What it will do, it will copy paste in the computer, and it will spoil all your files from the computer. Yes, it will spoil everything. So when if you have written something, your internet is not working, your system is not, one finder you'll open and nothing is opening. It will only show you error. Why? Because there's a malware attack in your computers. Yes. So who develops these programs and why do they develop it? There are computer programmers. There are people whom we call it as programmers, software programmer, who develop such kind of softwares to hack the computers. Why do they do it? To hack the computers. They are also known as hackers, as I said. Some hack the machine for fun. Why do they do it? Just like that, just for fun. Okay, why do you take others' mobile? Just for fun. Like that, some people are just for fun, while some are professions. Some does this profession only. However, why do they profession? In the sense, like they want to have online theft, earn money out of it. So for online theft only, they do it. Yes. But children, hacking is a punishable crime and may lead to imprisonment. When I say punishable crime, is it? See, it is just like stealing money only, right? Without information, if somebody gets into your house and takes all your personal stuff, what will you do? You'll do police case only, right? Likewise, any information available on our computer system is being stolen from our system by these hackers. It is also called as a theft. Yes, it is also called as theft. So any kind of a theft is punishable. So hacking is also a punishable crime. And it may lead to imprisonment. In the sense, you might go to jail also. Yes, there are various ways to protect your computers from malware as well as to remove malware from the computer system. But we must remember, children, that there is no one method which is completely enough to ensure that your computer is secure. There is no only one method. You have to go for multiple methods to save your computers. These five children requested Mr. Soffan to explain in the detail the various measures that should be taken to protect the computer system. So what are those measures? I'll be telling in my next video. Until then, bye-bye.